compatible. So it should also have 64 MP camera of quadruple camera. Then I will pay 10,000 rupees. That is the kind of demand in future the IoT device designers are going to face. I said one example by taking a cell phone. I said another example by taking the R&D equipment. But ultimately, what I wanted to say, cost effectiveness without compromising performance and power consumption. That's the requirement. Cost effectiveness without compromising performance and the power consumption. That's the requirement. Okay. I think with this, I'll once again give you a few other things. As I told you, the terminology aspects. People talk about big data, people talk about deep learning, machine learning, artificial intelligence, software-defined networking, software-defined radio, 5G-related MIMO, massive MIMO, and booming loops. Basically, the beam techniques, beam focusing techniques. And other people talk about the cloud computing, mobile cloud. Some people talk about edge computing, mobile edge computing, fog computing, cloudlets, cognitive computing, 5G technologies. These are all various terminologies. Data mining, big data. All these terminologies are, passionate terminologies. But what is the meaning of them? Mobile computing, edge computing, generally mobile edge computing and edge computing, they are related. If your application is, mobile based, or the user in the mobile state, then we call that particular device computing as mobile edge computing. Fog computing, as I told you, it talks about the communication aspects. It looks for efficient, energy efficient communication algorithms to route your data transmission from one to another. The cloud computing, which is a huge infrastructure and big business, they come with the free, they take a lot of money. And the mobile cloud, it's once again another form of the cloud computing. And it's a huge computing. The example is sometimes, throughout the globe data they want to collect. They want to collect Antarctica data, they want to collect the American continent data, they want to collect Asian continent data, like that. So at that point of time, the cloud infrastructure is moving. Maybe the satellite is having cloud. Also, the environment is going to have the satellite-based moment in the Earth. So those things are going to come there. And 5G technology, if you want really excel IoT technology, then you have to learn the 5G technologies, MIMO technology within the 5G. See, please don't think 5G is going to bring miracles. Today, whatever you are talking, the duplex system, you are going to have multiples of duplex system to fulfill the 5G requirement. Not more than that. Not more than that. I am repeating, not more than that. MIMO systems are giving you multiples of the data bandwidth. Okay, this satellite data bandwidth is already high. we are unable to consume because of the single duplex transceiver technology. So we are going to have lot many AI technologies used in the 5G. Now, deep learning, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. If you talk about everything artificial intelligence, if you are talk about only few things with the mission related, mission made automatic, then it's machine learning. Mission made human brain, then we can talk about a deep learning. So when it comes to the 5G technology, there are software defined networking so that in the multiple protocols support software defined radios so that in the multiple physical layer protocols support. Hence these technologies are coming into the IoT technology. So basically, what anybody can look into that, look at the terminology, understand the essence of the terminology, try to implement the functionality of that particular terminology. And when you talk about big data, today big data is not the new term, but today big data is more important. The data scientist, data analyst. Why was it not there earlier? It was there. But why today data scientist became more popular than any other fellow? Like wherever there is a money, the terminologies are becoming more popular. Once upon a time, software engineer. Before that, engineer. Now data scientist, data analyst. What they are going to do? They are going to simply implement in the form of deep learning, either DNN or CNN. In the machine learning, either SVM or kernel-based or PCA. In the AI-based, perception. Perception means image sensor or any sensor that gives you touch or smell or acting and reacting capability. Only these things, they are not straight away interfaced. They are intelligent based so that machine itself can act like human. IoT device plays a lot of role in coming future robotic technology. So in coming, why robot? Robot has everything. Why can't it be others? Let it be other name, but the functionality is same. Since many people are talking about robots, so I'll give cobot. So what cobot is doing? It does the cooperation among neighbor robots. Okay, fine. Then cobots already somebody has used. I'll use intelligent cobot or smart cobot. Some new terminology generally brings the terminology, new terminology generally comes from computer science branch. It's like, putting the old wine in a new bottle. The function is same or similar. I should not say same. I take my word back. Similar or a few addition or few things deletion. Other than that, the terminology does the, nothing. So big data today is more important because IoT producing a lot of data. IoT devices are producing a lot of data. And 5G is more important because the communication aspects gets increasing. The user demanding more and more services. So the designers have to look into the where he can do a best computing, either in the edge computing or fog computing or cloud computing, depending upon the application that he needs to understand. Okay, so with this, I'll give you a few more things. What I can give you. Okay, ultimately, the feeling of deployed system is like this. Ultimately, the feeling of deployed system is, you can see this is, you know, a Zigbee based, this is, you know, something, another Zigbee based, another Zigbee based, and everything is Zigbee based, no problem, one single server. But I can also use BLE here, and here LoRa, and here Wi-Fi, and here Zigbee, and different communications also, I can use it, and then I can send the data to the server. And this is generally distributed IoT or cyber physical system scenario. Cyber physical system scenario. So there are many communication protocols generally they are having. So mostly we don't want to see. Now let us see the various issues really, you know, related to the IoT. As I told you, already I have covered the communication protocols and the concept of context-aware data analysis, and intelligent spectrum management is the key issue. Of course, high-speed multi-layer hybrid distributed communication network is the another one, and the mobile communication aspect is the next one. So what we can do after this, I would like to conclude. When you talk about the wireless standards, different standards and different vendors are available. I am completely using TI from the beginning. So I'm giving TI based standards. See, every company is giving the same, almost similar. So only the thing is, I use TI based chips. So these are all various chips. See, multi-protocol chips are available. Multi-protocol support chips are available. That is, you know, 1352R, CC1352R is supporting a proprietary set protocol, sub-gigahertz, as well as the Bluetooth 5 and low energy Zigbee and Thread. These are all various standards that it's supporting. And proprietary based FSK format is also they are supporting. Similarly, the 2652RB is the latest one. It is also supporting the Bluetooth and the 5 low energy Zigbee and the Thread. But it is you know in the sub gigahertz, but it is in the 2.4 gigahertz. So similarly, for any vendor, you can take their chips. And you can look into the important parameters. What anybody wants, you want a flash to store your program. You want RAM to run your program. You want the GPIOs to have to connect the sensors to acquire the various sensors. How many sensors are you are having? So can you connect all of them using available GPIO? That is the real requirement before you do design. And what kind of ADC you are having? So what is the internal architecture of your chip? That one has to look into. What kind of interface protocols I'm having? Are they sufficient? If they're sufficient, then I'll go ahead with this. Otherwise, I'll change my chipset. So this is one aspect. So next one is, yeah, this is what we have already implemented using chipset. MSP430 and CC2520 together acts like a Zigbee plus a computational unit, and this is used for the debugger, and these are the packet sniffers, and this is the IER environment that what we are, you know, using as a WSN node for structural augmenting applications. So I think I'll conclude. Basically, with this, I'll try to, whenever you try to design any system, one has to look into the functional requirement. The another, you need to see the physical requirement. So the functional requirement forces you chipset, and also forces you the system architecture. And the functional requirement is also related with the communication. Then you look into the various communication protocols. The moment you talk about the communication protocol, the operating system comes into the picture. The operating system details I have not given you because of the time aspect. Operating system generally should support the required communication protocol for the required chipset, then only it is possible. Otherwise, making your own way is almost impossible, or it takes a lot of time. So many companies, they are providing really a confusing way of products. They claim everything. When it comes to that, everything means with our own system. You buy everything from us, it will work fantastically. And do you provide according to my application? They won't provide you. So that one has to look into carefully. That is the one of the important aspect anybody wants to see. The another one is application requirement. In the application, it's not only simply functionality of the application, also deployment of the application requirement. Also, the environment of the application deployment, those aspects also one has to look into, and then try to use the systems engineering aspect of what I said. And protocols, when it comes to the protocols, computer science people are happy with the TCP/IP architecture model. Triple E and other people may not be happy with that, but don't worry. You simply assume there is a protocol stack that is available, and you assume that entire protocol stack as a C program function. And you need to pass the information into the protocol stack, and you take the data from the protocol stack. That means assume protocol stack as a single function with the input argument and output argument. And you should know how to send your data to in the form of input argument, and you should know how to take the data from the protocol stack as output from the output argument. That's it. So once if you have done, then rest of the things are in your hand. Similarly, the computer science guys can look into, okay, you can assume there is a sensor data is available, and this many samples, like 10,000 samples per second, each data is, you know, floating point data. Am I able to send the data? If I cannot, then where I can improve the data, you know, communication protocol or protocol stack. So those aspects can be, you know, implementable. What I wanted to say, anybody can do a IoT design. Certain things you can do your own hands. Certain things you take them as a user. If you can develop, it's the best, it's excellent. If you cannot develop, you take them as a ready-made module and try to understand how to use it. And then complete your IoT system design, and then deploy look at the deployment requirement and then pass those requirements also to them. Okay, any doubts? Hello? Hello?
Sir, I am giving mute option for everyone, for the participant. Participant, if you wish, you can interact. I have unmuted your all options. So if you wish to interact with the scientist, you can interact. It's a great opportunity for all of you. So instead of chat window, kindly you can unmute and use audio note for the interaction. Another 30 seconds, I'll give you the chance for interaction with the scientist. It's a fortunate for all of us to interact with a great scientist like one of like this resource person. So if you want to interact, you take this opportunity and you can interact audio note rather than using chat window. But again, all of you are using chat window only. That's Hello. Fine.
No. Yeah.
Sir, none of them are into audio notes, sir. They are only thanking and saying wonderful session. We want this PPT resource and excellent session. Several comment has come, sir. What are components in wireless sensor network? This is the only question available, sir.
See, already I have told you, wireless sensor network, when you talk about what is the requirement, one is node, the other one is the protocol. See, wireless sensor network generally term comes from ad hoc network. So 10 years or 15 years back, people used to talk about ad hoc networking. Now, wireless sensor network has many protocols, like BLE is a wireless sensor network. Wi-Fi can also be treated as a wireless sensor network. Zigbee can also be treated as a wireless sensor network. So these are all various protocols. That means one is protocol aspect. Second one is the device where the protocol is executing, also able to take the data, also able to do some small computing. So the chipset, that means ARM M3 is okay, ARM Cortex M3 is okay, or ARM Cortex M4 is okay, or ARM Cortex A53 is okay. What is that computation that you require to do within the wireless sensor network? That is the another aspect. So the most important aspect is what is the ADC and the sense, you need to capture the data from the sensors. So you required ADC if the sensor is analog. So ADC required sampling period, resolution, and the latency. These are the three things, important things. If they are matching to your application, it's good. If they don't match, then look for the other chipset where the ADC gives you satisfactory answer. For example, accelerometer data. You required 16-bit, and you required 10,000 samples per second, and you required more number of channels. That means how many accelerometer sensors are placing at a particular point. So one or two or three. So three channel and 16-bit resolution and 10 kilo samples per second is more than sufficient. So you need to look into those aspects.
Hello,
okay.
Sir.
Yeah,
good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, this is Avinash. My question is that the technology is improving day by day, like anything, and the world is moving very fast, and we are connected with the many sensors and many these things, like I explained very well. So my question is that, like, today, even we are the humans, the as you told that the computer is getting more faster than us, and we are the implementers finally. But the thing is like the putting the old wine in the new bottle, that's fine, right? But the thing is like how this technology will be overcome, like it is going to taking the humans, right? Like it is getting more intelligent, right? And even nowadays the for getting the birth, for giving the birth for the new people, these chances are going to be taking it is going to take the what we say even the births are not going to take place due to these sensors. How this will be eradicated with respect to these sensors? We need to use these sensors, or we need to restrict these sensors. Why? Because if everything is start being robots, right? Like I can accept that the work should be done efficiently and very fast. So is it required? As in the pandemic situation, we are even the kids like fourth class, fifth class people are using, and they are getting addicted, right? And they are getting like they are affecting their eyes and ears and everything, right? So how it will be like in future, and even the age restrictions will be getting less of the humans, right? Yeah, even as rightly quoted that we see the every time we see the product based like whatever we are purchasing, like we are investing 1 lakh rupees for the iPhone. We see the like their performance and these things, and we need to see our performance of our life, right? Why? Because as we are human, we need to work efficiently. So how these sensors will be affecting our things, sir? How they are going to develop these sensors?
See, if you see, you're a faculty or a student?
Yeah, I'm a faculty, sir.
So how old you are?
I'm like 31, sir.
Right. So before 31 years means it's not much, but you can also see. When you were studying, what was the classroom environment?
Yes, sir.
It is only chalk. If I see, there is no even a smart board.
Yes.
So today, your children are going to have not only smart board, also smart class.
Smart class.
He will be with you and attending the class. Without suffering anything, neither she is suffering, nor she, due to her class is suffering. So that kind of feature is going to have just because of the sensor productivity or output of the sensor only. The reason is augmented reality has to be created, and it has to capture the environment. So when you capture the environment, according to environment, you need to do a computing. The computing becomes cheaper, but tomorrow the money comes for, or the product value is only for the energy consumption and the functions that it is serving. It won't no more based on the processor capacity. It is based on work capacity. Is it giving me intelligency so that you know I can use as my personal assistant? If not, I don't use it. So this kind of environment only comes through sensor aspects. So sensors are more important than earlier. There are industry based sensors only used. Now you need to use more sophisticated than the industrial based, because your body is going to implant the sensors so that you know it will monitor completely your health aspects. For example, is getting the sugar, and the blood sample, it continuously success, and that person takes the, you know, by chance if he wants to eat any sweet, your body itself, the machine itself tells you, look, Mr. X, you are already having this much sugar. you cannot take. Let us say your neighbors or your friends, your relatives, if they are giving forcefully, your chip says, look, he has a diabetic, please don't give him. So instead of human being, the chip is going to take care. So that kind of environment we are going to see. So it has a lot of feature in the sensors. But do you have a capability to make the sensor? That's the more important. Design, not okay. Design, okay, if you are having fabrication facilities. Am I clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay, I think no other question is there.
Sir, I think there is no more question either in the chat window and in the audio notes, sir. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation. Your session was highly informative. Really, the holistic picture has been brought to the session. It's a faculty development program, sir. It is a fifth day. It's a kind of summarization. It's a kind of all the things, whatever happened. We have got very much insightful from your session, sir. And really, I enjoyed your PPT, the animated version, and it was so meaningful way of animation. Really amazing, sir. Even I wanted to learn from you, sir, this animated PPT, how to create. And the highlights are, it's an off time, and the fifth day we have invited you. A complete picture has been brought to this STTP. That is the awesome factor of your contribution, sir. Thanks a lot for accepting our invitation. Thank you so much. From the participants also, more than 30 appreciations I could see, sir. More than 30 plus appreciations. Very nice session, informative session. These are all the kind of appreciation they are giving, sir. It's our honor and it's our pride moment having you as a great scientist in our session. Industry and academicians only so far now they were becoming a resource person. You are the first scientist in this STTP to compensate that feel also. We have got, we are fortunate and lucky. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all, dear participants. Let us meet by 2 o'clock for the afternoon session. Thank you one and all. So everyone is expressing their thanks and gratitude to the resource person as well. And it's great to see your enthusiasm and your appreciation. Thank you all. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.